Application of Microsoft Word to make documents. Welcome to this Labs for Life video on the use of Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word is frequently used to make documents. This video will tell you about the use of various features of Microsoft Word to create different quality management system documents, such as SOPs and formats for your use in the lab. We will discuss different functions including inserting a cover page, inserting a header and footer, page numbering, editing and formatting of text, keyboard shortcuts, saving, password protection, and creating folders. Requirements: a computer system which has Microsoft Office installed. Opening a new Word file. Right-click on your desktop. Select New, Microsoft Office Word document. An icon will appear on the desktop. Right-click on the icon. Go to Rename. And you can rename the document as required. Here we are naming it ABC Lab. To open the blank document, you can either double click on the icon or right click and click on Open to open the document. Designing an SOP. We will now explore features of MS Word using the example of a sample standard operating procedure document. What you can see here is a sample SOP. It has a specified header, formatted text. So, how do we go about making such a document? Let's go back to the new document we just created. On the top of the screen, you can see the toolbar which has various tabs, each of which contains various tools. First, let us talk about inserting a cover page. To insert a cover page, click on the Insert tab on the left top corner of the screen. Click on Cover Page. Once you click the cover page, you will find a number of cover page designs. Any of the design can be selected. Once you click on selected design, the page will show on the screen. You can enter the relevant details of your document like document title, subtitle, date, author, etc. Any extra text boxes may be deleted by right-clicking and selecting delete rows. Inserting a header and footer. Next, let us talk about headers and footers. Headers and footers can be used to give a uniform look to the pages of your document. Inserting a footer or header in one page will ensure that it is carried forward into all pages except the cover. A complete standardized header is required here as described in earlier videos. It should include all the elements of ISO 15189, clause 4.3b. It also should contain details of who prepared the document and who authorized the issue or reissue. As per ISO 15189 clause 4.3, each page should have page number as in unique identifier of the document and title. Page number so-and-so of total number of pages. For example, page 1 of 5, page 2 of 5, and so on. To create one, go to Insert tab, Header and Footer, and select one as per the last prerogative. First, we will demonstrate how to make a header. Use the toolbar, go to Insert and select a header. Modify the header by inserting a table and include the requirements as specified by the standard. That is, name of the lab, unique identifier of the document, page number in the format of page number so-and-so of total number of pages. To insert a table, go to Insert tab, Tables box, Table button. Select the number of columns or rows required. To modify your table, when your table is selected, a Design tab and Layout tab will appear in the toolbar. You can add cells, columns, or rows, merge or split cells, and further modify your table. The information entered in the header will now appear on all the pages of the document. Inserting a footer. For inserting a footer, go to Insert, select Footer, Add Footer. A number of formats for the footer will be displayed, any of which may be selected. As done in the header, we will insert a table here to include all the required information. Page numbering. The page number as per the standard requirements can be directly entered into the header or footers. Select the location in the tools, either header or footer. Go to Insert, go to Page Numbers. Select the current position option. Then scroll down till you see the option in bold numbers and select this. This will enable your page numbers to show as page 1 of 2, page 2 of 2. Now that you have understood the details of how to format header or footer, let us look at some more features of MS Word. Formatting text. Let us go back to the sample SOP. See the text and how it is formatted. We will now try to format text in our own document similarly. We are selecting the text from this document and pasting it in our document to show how we can format it in the same way. Numbered and bulleted list. To create a bulleted or number list, click on the numbering or bulleted button on the paragraph toolbar in the Home tab. Home, Paragraph, select a bullet list. Home, Paragraph, select a numbering. Home, Paragraph, select multi-leveling. To format your paragraph, first highlight the paragraph you wish to format. To highlight more than one paragraph, click at the beginning of the paragraph and drag the mouse over the text. To apply changes to the entire document, select all by hitting Ctrl plus A. We may select our own font style, size, color, and attributes such as bold, italic, underline, and highlighted in the Home tab as demonstrated here. To specify alignment, line spacing, indentation, and page break, expand the paragraph section of the Home tab. This will open up the paragraph menu. The alignment option allows you to choose how you want your paragraph to look, that is, justified, right, center, or left. The line spacing option allows you to set the desired spacing, such as single or double. The indentation option allows you to tap, push the lines in your paragraph, either left or right. Some other features of Word include inserting a picture. Insert, Pictures, select the location from where you would like to pick up the picture. Inserting a shape. Go to the Insert tab, Illustrations box, Shapes, and click the New Drawing Canvas. Inserting Smart Art. Smart Art graphics are the collection of graphical lists and process diagrams such as charts, cycles, pyramids, hierarchy, and relationship matrix. This is a feature which helps to make organogram in a document, which is a requirement of quality manual. You can see some examples here. Making flowchart. This is a very important feature for depicting process flow, especially in quality manual annexures, QSPs, SOPs, and bench aids. Sorting text in MS Word. Alphabetic sorting option in paragraph helps to arrange the selected matter in alphabetic wise, ascending or descending order. This is very useful if we are trying to make abbreviations and glossary in a document. What you see here is a document with abbreviations and their full forms. To sort the abbreviations in alphabetical order, select the column with the abbreviations, Home tab, Sort icon, Sort by column 1, Select Ascending. Click on OK. The list of abbreviations will now be ordered. Designing formats on MS Word. The third part of this video talks about designing formats on MS Word. Let us again see a sample format and try to develop a similar one. What you see here is a breakdown history sheet of a lab. The header contains all the information that needs to be entered in the format on the regular basis. There is a space to enter the information in the table inserted on the main page. We will now open a new blank document. Click on File, New, Blank Document. The header will be inserted in a similar manner as explained earlier. A table will be needed to insert it in the header. We will enter the same titles as shown in the sample format. Column titles may be formatted by going to Table Tools, Layout. The direction of the text may be changed by clicking on Text Direction. Check all the cells of the table and delete any unrequired lines by right-clicking after selecting the rows to be deleted and clicking on Delete Rows Shift Cells Up. Now that the header is ready, we will insert a table in the main body of the document. Specify the number of rows and columns to be drawn in the table. Select Table Drawn, Table Tools, Layout, Modify Height, Width, and Distribution of the cells. The cells may also be dragged to adjust their width and height. Number of rows in the table may be increased by clicking outside the last row of the table and clicking Enter. Each click will add a new row. The text may be modified further, just as we modified paragraphs. Saving a document. Saving initially. Before you begin to type, you should save your document. To do this, go to File tab and press Save As. Microsoft Word will ask you to choose a location and then browse to a folder to save it in. After selecting these, dialog box will open and you can name the file. Password protection. Some documents may need to be protected with a password. To do this, click on File tab, Info, Permissions, Encrypt with password, enter a password, OK, re-enter password, and then press OK. The document will be now password protected. Every time this document is opened, MS Word will first ask for the password, making the document secure. Storage of documents. Right-click, New, Folder, rename the folder. You may also create subfolders for different levels of documents in the folder as demonstrated. Add all the required documents into the folder by dragging. Shortcuts. Ctrl plus K creates a hyperlink. Ctrl plus forward slash display HTML tags. Ctrl plus Shift plus B preview a page in a web browser. Ctrl plus A select whole document. Ctrl plus N create a new page. Ctrl plus B bold. Ctrl plus I, italic. Ctrl plus U, underline. Ctrl plus C, copy. Ctrl plus V, paste. Ctrl plus Z, undo. Ctrl plus S, save. Ctrl plus P, to print. Ctrl plus O, to open.